there! You're watching Goldilocks and the Three Bears!
Hey! Stop! Why don't you get it? This is still my story. This is all about me. I am the big bad wolf. Hey! Stop that! Stop pushing me out!
My goodness. if you look a sight. After her meal was done, she felt quite tired. A warm place to sleep is what she desired. She saw the cozy beds, large, medium, and small. To take a nap, she dived in, rolled up like a ball. Goldilocks, must you want it all? She climbed in the big bed, it was hard and comfy. The medium bed was too soft and not at all comfy. But the little bed to her felt just right. She closed her eyes and whispered, good night. Goldilocks, my love, this isn't quite right. She didn't know whose beds, bowls, and chairs. They belonged to a family of the three brown bears. The bears came home and to their dismay, their home was topsy-turvy in a bad way. Goldilocks, this is no more a child's play.
Someone sat in my chair,
said Daddy Bear. Someone sat in mine too, said Mommy Bear.
And tasted my porridge and slept in my bed.
My porridge and bed's been touched, Mommy saw red. Goldilocks, my dear, it's time you fled. But for little Baby Bear, the worst was done. His chair was broken and his porridge was gone. He cried his heart out, this just ain't fair. He checked his bed and someone was still there. Goldilocks, my love, you are in for a scare. Tucked under the covers and lost in dreams was a golden haired girl dreaming of kings and queens. She dreamt that she was in a palace of light. She felt that she could sleep there all night. Goldilocks, wake up or be ready for a fright. She slowly opened her eyes and saw three brown bears with sharp teeth and big claws. She screamed and jumped off the bed to the floor. She dashed past the bears and ran out the front door. Goldilocks, run, I can hear the bears roar.
Lesson. She won't be touching things without permission.
The moral goes, if it's not your bowl, bed, or chair, please don't meddle, it may belong to a bear. Goldilocks, my dear, you should really take care.
Ha 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 chasing my sheep. The big bad wolf is chasing my sheep. The wolf is chasing my flock of sheep. It's not a lie and it's not a trick. I need your help to save my sheep. The big bad wolf is chasing my sheep. The big bad wolf is chasing my sheep. Was a silly, stupid game. The people of the village ignored him, and there was no one to help him. The moral of the story is to never lie, as no one would believe you when you lie. No one would believe you when you lie.
One day she baked a gingerbread man. As soon as he was out of the oven, he jumped out of the pan and ran. Run, run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch me, I'm the gingerbread man. Run, run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch me, I'm the gingerbread man. He passed a pig by the trash can. He wanted to eat the gingerbread man. He did not want to eat his bran. He joined the chase and off he ran. Run, run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch me, I'm the gingerbread man. Run, run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch me, I'm the gingerbread man. Next he passed the cow and her milkman. She wanted to eat the gingerbread man. She didn't fill milk in her can. She joined the chase and off she ran. Run, run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch me, I'm the gingerbread man. Run, run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch me, I'm the gingerbread man. Wanted to eat the gingerbread man. He didn't want to pull a moving van. He joined the chase and off he ran. Run, run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch me, I'm the gingerbread man. Run, run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch me, I'm the gingerbread man. By the dam. How would he cross over? He had to plan. A sly fox came posing as a fisherman. He popped him on his tail and off he swam. Swim, swim, swim as fast as you can. You can't catch me, I'm the gingerbread man. Swim, swim, swim as fast as you can. You can't catch me, I'm the gingerbread man. The gingerbread man didn't know what had began. The sly fox had a master plan. From his tail to his nose fan, he got poor gingerbread into a frying pan.
Help, 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 there is no way you can. You've been caught, poor gingerbread man. Help, 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 there is no way you can. You've been caught, poor gingerbread man. The fox flicked him into the air like a fan. Swallowed him in one gulp like a tasty can. The chase finally ended with this one man. And that was the end of the gingerbread man. Help, 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 there is no way you can. You've been caught, poor gingerbread man. Help, 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 there is no way you can. You've been caught, poor gingerbread man. To play some golf. He got tired as he played. He lay down to rest under a shade. His tummy rumbled as he lay. He needed some food that very day. Across the meadow he saw some sheep. Smacking his lips he leaped. Boy, his trusty dog ran barking with joy. The wolf couldn't get close to the flock. He became a laughing stock. He wanted to roast some lamb in his pan. He found a sheepskin on the ground. He wanted with the skin himself surround. He crept slowly into the flock of sheep. No one knew that his look was skin deep. He led a lamb out of the group and cooked it into a yummy soup. To get his tummy full to the brim. But bad deeds never go unpunished. Evildoers are always demolished. Taken to the pen with the other sheep, he was kept on a chain. The farmer came out to cook a feast. He needed a big fat sheep at least. He caught the wolf in sheep's clothing, cooked him to perfection with everything. And that was the end of the big bad wolf. Maybe he should have just played golf. Descriptive appearances can be deceptive. However, evil thoughts will end always in a bad way, my friend.
Yes. Yes.
Yoo-hoo!
Please click to subscribe and don't forget to hit the bell icon to get updates on our new videos.